Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Star Wars Battlefront, running on the Xbox One X. Now, it has been quite some time since Battlefront was added to the backwards compatibility program, but it has been also quite some time since I've given it a go. So what we're going to do today is do that very thing and give it a go, see how it holds up today, because it has been remastered, of course, and this is the original one, which I believe came out in 2004. It may have been 2003. I should check these things before I start recording. But to actually demonstrate this game, we're going to be doing the instant action, which is the, well, in my opinion, the best way to experience this game, because you can just choose between all of the different maps, all of the different factions, and all of the different game modes, which is really quite cool. Now, one thing I will note about this is that from all of the other games I've played that were on the original Xbox via backwards compatibility, this is one of the very few which has been upgraded to 16:9. Now, I'm not entirely sure if this was running in 16:9 on the original Xbox, but if it wasn't, they've definitely upgraded this to 16:9, and we're currently running in 4K as well, so it looks quite up to date, really, apart from some of the textures being a bit old, of course. But as you can see, 4K looks quite good as far as I'm concerned. Now, whether or not this has been Xbox One X enhanced, I do not know. Actually, it could have been. Who are we going to play as? I think we're going to play as the default clone trooper. Here we are. Now, one thing about this game which sticks in my head is this point of view. Now, I don't think you can change. Can you change? Why is he running into me? Okay. I don't believe you can change the point of view. You can aim, you can throw a grenade, and you can shoot, obviously. Then you can reload. B's crouch. Is B go prone or is B crouch? B's crouch, then you can go prone by holding it. Okay. And then you press... Oh, we better kill this guy. Oh no, that's not aim. This is aim. Now, one thing you may have noticed is that this is pretty quiet. I've actually turned off the music to avoid copyright claims on YouTube for the video, because that will cause me some problems. And but yeah, the FOV seems pretty zoomed in, doesn't it? That's actually quite annoying. Oh, the clones are behind us. Look at this. Bloody buggers are behind us. I wonder if we can get on this. That would be cool, wouldn't it? Let's see if we can actually hitch a ride. Yeah, we can. Now, it's nearly out of health. But I bet this one here has got more health. Yeah, it's full health. Look at this. Now, I want to see if I can actually change the FOV, because that's one thing about this which is kind of annoying. Game options. No, we can't. Okay. Viewpoint third person. First person. Let's try that. Let's try first person, so you can switch to first person and third person. It doesn't look like the FOV has changed, and you can kind of see some ghosting. That's kind of strange, isn't it? The way the atmosphere is kind of... How would I describe that? It's got like a layer of haze across it. And you can see on the minimap all of the action. Now, this is actually quite exciting for the time. I remember when this first came out, people were really excited to give this a go, because it was one of the first times we'd seen really big-scale battles. And that hasn't really been replicated since... other than things like Battlefield and the Battle Royale games. So obviously it's been replicated more recently, but at the time this was like pretty well unheard of for the most part. You know, big scale battles were relatively new, even though the Battlefield universe was in its youth as well. And actually, quite interestingly, the two remasters of this game, Battlefront 1 and 2, were done by EA. I think they were done by DICE, actually, the same people that do Battlefield. So there's quite a lot of pedigree in the Star Wars license, I guess you could say. And this is where it all started. Now, we're not doing very well here, are we? We're less on the scoreboard here. We need to go and capture some of these bloody nodes. Now, one thing about Battlefront, which I always seem to tell people whenever I play this, is that I'm not au fait with Star Wars knowledge. So, the lore, not my thing. I literally just played this for the gameplay, and that's the same today. I don't know anything about the films, don't know anything about the expanded universe or anything like that. So, this is going to be a real layman's explanation of the Star Wars games, I suppose you could say. But for the most part, this is just a shooting game. And when we zoom in, the crosshair sort of moves upwards. That's quite irritating, isn't it? I don't know, can we... We can't open... Right, so it's not a 360 game, so you can't open the 360 menu, which makes sense, actually. But the one thing I'll criticize about this, although it is an old game, the crosshair and the HUD and the FOV is really zoomed in and kind of annoying, actually. I don't like the way the game sort of appears from, well, I guess, the way you play, or the perspective that you play, I should say, because it's kind of, it's not giving me, it's not quite making me ill. Oh, well, we got wasted there. It's not quite making me ill, but it is just a little bit too zoomed in, especially compared to things more recent. Now, the textures look a lot better here, don't they? Look at this. The textures look way, way better than they do in game. Let's try out the ARC Trooper. This guy's got a big, what would you call this? An ARC launcher, I guess you'd call it. There's a guy there. Switch to the pistol. Get on, buddy. There we go. I don't know. No, the health isn't regenerating. So the red stuff that you pick up on the map in those little canisters are ammo. And the blue stuff is health. So, oh, are we dead? No, I think our health in the top right-hand side there hasn't changed. So we haven't died just yet. But this guy's going to be a bit of a pain in the ass by the looks of it. Do we have to wait for his shield to disappear? Perhaps? Oh, we absolutely got wasted again. We're actually getting our asses handed to us here. That's a little bit of a shame. We do need to be pushing here. Who can we check out now? Oh, a jet trooper. Let's check out the jet trooper. How do we work this? Oh, so you just tap A. Okay. And then you... Oh, is that it? You can literally just hover. This guy has got the command pistol, the EMP launcher, and that's it, and grenades. Oh. This isn't going to be good. Can we kill this dude? Don't know if we're going to be able to kill this tank in any sort of meaningful time. Looks like he's going to be absolutely shitting on us. Be good if we could get in a tank, actually. Is there any tanks on the battlefield? This looks like a thing. What is this? What is this? That's on the map as well. Enter and exit turret. Oh. Oh, I see. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that does quite a bit more damage, doesn't it? Mounted turrets. Have we killed the thing inside it? Nope, there it goes. The health is going down. Absolutely destroyed. We'll kill the drone as well. The droid, not the drone. The droid, not the drone. And I just saw a glitch on my recording software there. Sorry about that. That was a brief moment of video pause, I think. I don't know if that's ruined the file or not. It doesn't seem to have touched it, which is good. So, yeah, this game holds up reasonably well. But I think most people remember the Battlefront games from the second one, if I had to sort of decide between this one or that one being the most sort of memorable. I would say it was definitely the second one, and we're going to take a look at the second one in another video too. So we are getting absolutely burrowed into the ground here, which is terrible. I thought I could at least win you a game while I'm recording here, but apparently not. And we're going to give this guy another try, because I think this big rocket launcher is going to be quite good. And you can actually stand next to these guys too, and they'll heal you. And the little box here, these guys will give you ammo, which is cool. I keep pressing the grenade button to bloody aim, which is quite irritating. Okay. I don't know if we have to wait for him to get his shield down or what's going on there. Oh, there we go. Okay, reload. Oh, his shield went back up. Oh, and we died. Okay. Well, it's evident that I'm terrible at this and we've nearly run out of tickets, which is great. I'm going to go back to the standard droid. Hopefully this is going to be a bit more worth your time. He's just got a normal blaster. Oh, you can roll. You can roll side to side. Look at that. That's cool. Did I just kill a friendly there? I think I might have done. Ah, we got the droidica. I think that's what they're called. Droidicas. Let me know in the comments if I'm right about that. Absolutely wrecked. Fantastic. And we'll throw a grenade at this guy. Because that seemed to be effective. Yep, there we go. Oh, grenades. We might be able to bring this back. Imagine that. Oh. Looks like there's some heavy aim assist, actually. So you can't roll forward. You can only roll side to side. Noted, noted. Guys down here. Now, something I actually forgot to mention at the start of the video is, if my voice sounds a little bit off, I have just recovered from the worst flu I've ever had in my life. So my voice might sound slightly different. Now, we've only got 4 tickets left. That's 4 lives. They've got 81 left. This isn't great, is it? Oh, dear. All right. I don't know if we have to capture the command posts to get the tickets or if they've got those tickets from actually killing us or not. I don't know if that's lives or if that's capture points. I'm not quite sure. Oh, it looks like these guys are going to shit on me anyway, though. That's heavy aim assist right there, guys. Let's actually see if I can capture this one. There should be some health nearby. Yep, we've picked up the health there. Oh, they are forming on us. Yeah, and we're dead. There we go. 0 lives left. Defeated. Don't let this happen again. Well, that's Star Wars Battlefront. We got the most kills. At least we got the most kills. 5 deaths. That's not too bad. That's actually quite an equal distribution between all of the different AI characters there. But Unit 538 killed way, way more than everything else. He seems to be like the Chad AI. And he's the virgin down at the bottom, 35 there. Right, well, that's Star Wars Battlefront. Been quite some time since I've given this a go, but it's kind of interesting to give it a go, I suppose, since it's on the Xbox One X. Let me know if you want to see any more from this, and thanks for watching.